Hello, and welcome to this live demo of BETA CAE Systems. This video will demonstrate a short introduction to the BETA GUI library of the ANSA API. BETA GUI is a powerful and versatile library of GUI functions. It is meant to help users build custom windows that consist of any type of graphical interfaces like line edits, combo boxes, checkboxes, lists, and more, in order to interact easier and more efficiently with ANSA entities. The BETA Window Designer is a tool that enables the easy generation of windows through a user-friendly graphical user interface. The great advantage of the designer is the automatic generation of the code that corresponds to the respective actions performed, which can be really useful, especially for inexperienced users. To access the designer, we firstly have to open the script editor and then press the Tools menu button and select Designer. Let's see a brief presentation of the designer's interface. The toolbox is the starting point of all the actions performed in the BETA Window Designer. It contains all the graphical entities that we can create, organized in different tabs according to their respective functionality. Initially, only the Window tab is active, since the first action is to create the window that will be used as the parent object of all the widgets. Let's expand the window tree and press the Apply Settings button to create our main window. This will make the rest of the categories available. Now, let's navigate to the Buttons tab and create a checkbox and a push button by expanding their trees and simply pressing Apply Settings. Both these objects are created on our window. We can see that expanding any object under any category will reveal a basic set of options necessary for the creation of the object. These options are actually the input arguments of a BETA GUI function, and thus they are characterized by their type and their value. Initially, the options have the default values, but they can also be set up by the user, except from those that are of type element. On the right, we can see the constructed items window, which lists all the created objects in a tree structure, making it easy to recognize any parent-child relationship. Here, we can see that the created buttons are under the top window, and we can also drag and drop any object to modify its position. Also note that the parent object controls the object's orientation. As you have just seen, any object that is added directly to the top window is distributed vertically. To control the order of the objects, we can create a predefined horizontal or vertical box layout and add the widgets in it. In our case, we will create a horizontal box from the Containers tab. And then simply drag and drop the buttons from the constructed items list inside the horizontal box. There is also the option of deleting an item by right-clicking on it and selecting Delete Item. The Common Parameters window lists all the actions that are considered as common for every object. For example, we can select the push button from the list and then select the Add Tooltip parameter, where we can type a custom text as the tooltip for the button. After applying, we can place the cursor over the button and see the created tooltip. The Parameters window lists all the unique functions that can be applied on a selected object. For example, having selected the push button object, we can select the button set text parameter and type a new value to modify its text. Every parameter, as well as every object constructor item from the toolbox, corresponds to a BETA GUI function. By selecting any of those, the documentation of the function appears on the Help window. The Source Code window is the area where the BETA GUI designer automatically constructs the code as soon as an action is performed. The source code is not editable and it is automatically modified only when an action is performed. However, it can be directly sent to the script editor through the Set Code to Script Editor button, where it can be manually edited. As a general remark, notice that the Designer tool produces the source code only for how the window looks and not how it behaves. The latter should be added manually by the developer together with the data collection and any other additional code. As a first example, let's try to create the window of the image. We will use the Designer tool to create all the appropriate graphical entities. So, let's create a new window and provide as a title the text My Window. Our window is successfully created, and now we can start adding to it the various widgets. The first item that we have to add is the button group, which can be found in the Containers tab. A button group consists of a title next to a checkbox and a border line around its contents. Let's select the button group create option and provide as a title the text Find Nodes Based on Location. Also, we have to set the BC Enum orientation option to BC horizontal in order for everything that will be added in the button group to have horizontal orientation. After pressing Apply Settings, the button group is created, and now we have to create its contents. The first widget that is contained in the button group is a combo box, which can be found on the Input tab. Here, we have to specify the values of the combo box, which in our case should be the letters X, Y, and Z. Also notice that the element P option has automatically taken the value BC button group 1. Because we have selected the button group on the constructed items list. This argument is the parent element, which indicates where the widget will be created. After creating the combo box, we then have to add a widget that will contain the less than symbol as text. The widget that we need is the label, which can be found in the Common Widgets tab. After selecting the label create, we have to select the button group as the parent element and set the appropriate text. The last widget that we have to create inside the button group is a line edit field, which can be found in the Input tab as a line edit. We will expand the line edit create double, and after selecting the button group as the parent element, we will press Apply Settings to create the line edit. The default number that can be seen on the val option corresponds to a blank line edit field. Our button group seems to be complete, however the spacing of the widgets has not been handled properly yet. A very useful widget is the one called spacer, which essentially is an invisible widget that simply occupies as much space as possible. In other words, when a spacer is created, it forces its neighboring widgets to occupy as less space as possible. In our example, we should first create a spacer inside the button group in order to push the combo box, the label, and the line edit to the left, and then create a spacer below the button group in order to push it to the top. Note that some of the spacing mechanisms might not always be visible on the designer, but they will be visible when the produced code will actually be executed. The final widgets that we have to create are the OK and Cancel buttons. To construct them, we will use the Dialog Button Box widget, which can be found on the Common Widgets tab. This will automatically create the two buttons on the bottom of the window. Finally, we should modify the already created button group in order to add a checkbox on its title. We need to select the button group and then execute the function button group sets checkable of the parameters window. The checkbox has been created and we can see that disabling and enabling the checkbox respectively disables and enables the button group and its contents. The front end of our window has now been created, and it's time to execute the produced code in order to see if everything is working as expected. To do that, we can press the Set Code to Script Editor button, and then go to the script editor and press the Run button. Our window pops up and we can see that everything has indeed been created and working as expected. Having created how the window looks, it is now time to add all the relevant functionality to it. Essentially, we would like the user to input all the required information, and then pressing the OK button should trigger the functionality execution. At first, let's add some blank lines to our code to make it more readable. Now, in order to handle the action of pressing the OK button, we should execute the function BCWindowSetAcceptFunction. Through this API, we will define the callback function that will be executed when the button is pressed. As arguments, we have to provide the window object, the callback function's name, and any optional data that we want to pass to it. Let's name it OKPressed, and for the time being, let's pass none as the data. After that, we can go on and create the function, which should have specific arguments as defined in the definition functions documentation. For our case, the busy window and the optional data argument. Inside this callback function, we firstly want to collect all the useful information from our window. As a first step to accomplish that, we have to pass as arguments the objects that contain information. These are the combo box and the line edit. So, instead of none, we will pass a list that contains those two objects. As a second step, we have to find the appropriate API functions to collect all the relevant information from the window. We will start by searching for a BC combo box function. And after a brief look, we can see that the function BCComboBoxCurrentItem returns the index of the current item. So, all we have to do is execute this function, provide it the ComboBox object, and also keep the return value in a variable. Similarly, we have to collect information of the lineEdit field. We will use the function BCLineEditGetDouble, because the lineEdit contains a double value. And again, we will provide the lineEdit object as argument. Having collected all the relevant information, we can now develop the core functionality of our window. We will call a different function to handle this procedure, which is very important as we always want to keep separated the GUI collection code from the functionality code. That's mainly because we might want to execute our code without GUI, and also keep our code as readable as possible. We will name the function findNodes and provide as arguments the information collected. Also, we should return true from our callback function in order for the window to properly close. Now, let's create the function findNodes. In here, we should use some of the API functions in order to collect all the nodes, isolate the ones we are interested in, and place them inside a new set. At first, let's import the base module. And then call the function base.collectEntities to get a list with all the nodes of the database. Then, we can execute a for loop on the nodes list and examine whether the selected axis coordinate value of the node is less than the specified position value. In that case, the node should be appended on an empty list called nodes list. Afterwards, we will call the function base.createEntity in order to create a new ANSA cell. And finally, we will execute the function base.addToCell in order to add all the nodes contained in the nodes list into the newly created set. Having completed the code development, we can press the Run button and test the window that we have created. Firstly, let's find the nodes with x coordinate less than 600. After pressing the OK button, we can see that a new set has been created containing the respective nodes. Then, we can execute again and choose the Y coordinate with value 300. Another set has been created, holding the appropriate nodes. Finally, we can select the Z coordinate with value 200. A third set is created, holding once again the correct nodes.